starts off with an opening statement.
Well, again, I'd like to thank our fans. They're with us the whole way, and it doesn't go unnoticed. So we appreciate them a great deal. Really proud of our kids. You know, we're having a rough time getting guys on base. Base hits are hard to come by, and we just kept fighting. And I thought we competed really well. Drew Parrish is a really, really good pitcher, and we hung in there long enough and made some good things happen there in the ninth. And I couldn't be more proud of our coaching staff and our kids. So let's ask the kids some questions.
Jake, Drew had y'all here for 8 innings, and then he came back out in the ninth, and that relay, he's going to be a little bit different. What about him looked different after the delay?
I'm going to be honest with you, he still had all of his stuff. I mean, he threw me all of his pitches that lasted back to lead the ninth off. I mean, he's an outstanding pitcher. He controlled 3 different pitches wherever he wanted to all game. He threw a changeup when he wanted it, where he wanted it, curveball, fastball at any time. I mean, that was a terrific start by him.
Mac, how good does it feel to be you right now?
Can't think. Like he said, that pitcher was one of the best we've seen all year. He had 3 different pitches that were very, very good. And, you know, it was just one of those things where you believe in yourself and the team, and it definitely paid off in the ninth inning.
Hey, Ethan, what was it like being in that dugout while that happens?
I think I blacked out. it was really exciting. I'm really happy for Elijah, happy for our team, especially how we started out. And just coming this far and doing what we've been able to do against some of the best teams in this country is pretty amazing. And I don't even have the words to explain how.
Hey, Jake, what was the mood sort of like during that rain delay for you guys?
I mean, we got a great group of guys. I mean, it was really relaxed and laid back, you know, even though we were 3 outs away from our season ending. You know, we were watching grown-ups in the weight room. So, you know, it was a real light in the weight room, and it was a good time.
And listening to that yodeling remix.
Mason Ramsey. Thank you. Thank you, Mason Ramsey.
Can you talk about your team's turnaround over the past couple days? Losing last night and coming back and getting the walk-off home run and continuing on in this tournament, all the emotions and up and downs in the last 24 hours?
Well, you're talking to the right guy for that question. Plenty of ups and downs. You know, when you play poorly, you wear it as a coach, no question. But as I mentioned, some of you were going to stay positive. We're going to talk about the specific things that we need to do to make the changes. I did it one-on-one during batting practice. I got to everybody that I wanted to talk to. That doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to happen, but that's the approach. If you're positive, you're relentless, the message doesn't change, kids buy in, and then you got a chance. And if you don't go down that path, I don't think you have a chance. And so I think Jake hit it on the head. We've got a really good group. I think the rain delay gives you a chance to relax. I think as long as you're grateful for the opportunity to compete, and grateful for the opportunity to wear Mississippi State uniform, I think then your perspective stays in line with where it should be. Those are the things I think.
I'm not sure I've seen you that excited after a game like that. What kind of went through your mind in that moment?
Well, about 30 seconds prior, I nudged Gautreau and I said, "Hey, man, Mac can run it off the scoreboard right here." Which, you know, we say those things in the dugout all the time, but that happened, you know. And I'm not calling the shot, but I'm saying there's belief. You know, I wasn't going down the other path. And yeah, I was fired up, Will.
Matt, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead. We can get back to Will later.
Matt, what did you see on that pitch? Mike Martin said he felt like it was a great pitch that Drew made.
That pitch was there all day. Change up. Just tell myself, scoot up as much as I can in the box and see it up. I mean, I knew after the fastball before that, he was coming with something, and I knew he was all over that changeup the whole inning. So I just said, keep my hands. hands back and do whatever I can to help this team.
I think right before the pitch came, you asked for a timeout. Was that before?
Yes.
What were you doing and what was kind of going through your head? It seemed like you seemed to know what was coming.
Yeah, he had a rhythm going, and I knew that with all their fans and stuff standing up going crazy, you know, just out of anyone's instincts, your emotions start going everywhere. So I stepped out, took a breather, got back in the box and said, keep fighting, and definitely paid off.
Coach, were you surprised to see Parrish go back out and start the ninth after the delay?
Well, I think any time that you get a 2.5 hour delay, you're probably surprised to see the starting pitcher go back out. But not shocked. That kid's quality. I watched him on TV in the ACC tournament last week. Hey, he's a top level competitor. He's playing. He's pitched. I saw the statistics of his last six starts. So in that regard, no, I'm not.
Hey, Gary, I know we asked about Riley quite a bit yesterday.
Yeah, let's talk about Riley Self some more.
Is he available for tomorrow?
I don't know. If it does, be sharp. You know, a lot of the things that you do pitching-wise, and I don't mean this any other way than just very straightforward, a lot of things that you do pitching-wise are predicated upon you trying to win weekends or you're trying to win regionals, you know, and so it's not all black and white just in the moment. That's in reference to the decisions yesterday. When those decisions are being made, I'm thinking that we're gonna win a game, and I'm trying to win a couple more games. I don't know if he's available or not. We'll find out tomorrow morning, though. But if he did, it'd be short.
So, what was the thinking to keep him in after the delay?
That if we don't hold him there, then it's gonna be really hard to play tomorrow. You know, and yesterday when you're making decisions, you think that you have three or four games here. Today, in the ninth inning, you're pretty clear what the options are. Hold them at two, maybe get three and keep playing, or go home. So I was really interested in staying and playing some more baseball in Tallahassee. And these guys are too.
You figure Billingsley will be on the mound start tomorrow?
Well, I should hope so. No, you got a real story.
Yeah.
Ethan, what was your plan of attack? They mixed up their lineup, got a lot of left-hand, right-hand switch guys.
Plan of attack's always the same. To me, I don't change anything based off their lineup. And obviously, if a guy can't hit a changeup, you don't change it. But as far as that goes, you just attack the zone, change speed when you need to, elevate, bury it. And I think that works against pretty much everybody.
Through more pitches than you would have preferred in the first, you kind of settled in and ended up going six. How did you kind of settle into?
It's just one of those things. You find a rhythm, and then once you start finding it, you start feeling it more, and you get more confident. And obviously, you'd like to start out that way. But I'm proud of how I did. I think I commanded all three pretty well. And the biggest thing is I gave our guys a chance to do what he did. Gives a chance to win the game.
Mac, I know you said you guys were confident going into the ninth inning, but it seemed pretty clear. I mean, you expected to go out there and do that. What made you feel that way? I mean, it was pretty obvious that you thought it was about to happen.
I mean, it's been us all year. It's been the legacy throughout Mississippi State. And I mean, just because it's the ninth inning doesn't mean you treat it any different. Kept telling, you know, we're in the dugout saying believe. Keep believing, trust it, do whatever you can to get on, and good things will happen. I mean, there's a great pitcher on the mound. Stayed with herself. Jake had a great at-bat, and Stovey did, and then, you know, just stuff like that's happened. It's magical.
Jake, how's it feel to know that you'll be putting on that uniform again at least one more time?
It's really good. This year's been a crazy one, but, this team fights, you know, all the 6 a.m. workouts we had in the fall, and, you know, all the workouts, practices, you know, I'm really proud of this team. And, our program. We had a really good crowd come this weekend too, you know, all the way down to Tallahassee. So it's an honor to put on this uniform. It really is.
This is a question for all the players. Have any of you ever been involved in a walk-off home run situation, by say in high school or at college, as dramatic as this?
Oh yeah,
against the school
year.
How many times?
Five or six this year. Not home run.
Yeah, walk-off home run like that.
Yeah,
against
against the school up north.
Yeah.
Luke Alexander hit one. That team that's wears blue on Sunday or whatever. Whatever that does. No, but that was a great feeling as well.
We've also had some doubles.
Doubles, same
Luke Alexander.
Luke Alexander against the same school that wears blue on Sunday.
Yeah.
And
Luke Alexander's a testament to this program. He has been a catalyst for us in big situations. He's our shortstop, and he's come through really big for us a lot. So to answer your question about the walk-off, that's Luke Alexander a lot.
Yep.
Jake, when you rounded third, I think you were the first MSU player to touch third base all game, outside of obviously third baseman. What was the reaction when you see that ball go over the fence?
I don't know. This team's an emotional roller coaster. I'm standing on second with a 1-2 count. Max steps out. I'm just like, oh gosh, this
is it. Pass the bat on.
Yeah, you didn't do that. But kind of take a deep breath. Like, oh God, Mac, you get this done for us, man. Like, I don't want to go home. And I see a changeup grip in his glove. I wanted to scream, changeup's coming. But I'm glad he saw it out of his hand, and Mac came through for us.
Jake, you'll say another thing for the highly ranked teams and beating those guys. I think they were 10-1 on the year. What's the key to success there?
Bulldogs. It's nothing you can really explain. We treat every game the same, but this team's been a lot of fun to watch in big games, and we're not done yet.
You were part of last year's team, came out of loser's bracket. Mm-hmm. Just, I guess, how do you get back to the championship and do what y'all did last year?
Well, it's going to take a good start out of JV tomorrow. It's going to take a team effort. It's going to take good defense and some quality at bats all the way through, like we have been, as of late. Offensively, Parrish just kept us out off balance today. Just credit to him. That was unbelievable what he did today. But it's just going to take one game at a time. I don't know who we're playing yet, Oklahoma or Samford, both great teams. We stayed up late and watched the Samford Florida State game. And, Samford can really pitch it. And then they hit the ball well last night, too. So, in Oklahoma, it's a really good ball club, too. Whoever we got tomorrow, we're going to come out. We're going to treat it like any other game. Just got to get it done.
Coach, one of the things that probably got people's attention here before you came here was that you guys swept the Gators. And, of course, Florida State lost all three. What was your – how did you do that? I mean, your impression, they're still number one team.
Yeah, I'm really straightforward and direct with our guys. And I think that even if I wasn't sitting here, that they would tell you that. You do it by playing well. And you do it by playing well a pitch at a time, a game at a time, an inning at a time. And it sounds, maybe trite or boring, but that's what the game is. It's monotonous repetition of the basic skills of the game. That's what our game is. And today we threw 150 pitches. And if you want to be really good, you got to lock in nine guys 150 times, for 3 seconds, and then you can get out, but you got to get back in. That's how you do it. You do it with that approach. You do it with a deep-seated belief in yourself, your coaching staff, your teammates, the players on the team. And then you like to compete. And we're at a really good place, and a really good conference. If you like to compete, Mississippi State's a really good place to be. And I think that in a nutshell is it. And obviously you got to perform well when it matters. But I don't think there's any secret. I don't think there's any magic other than the belief in yourself and your teammates. And if you have a bunch of really good teammates, then I think it makes it a little bit easier. And I think we got really good kids on our program.
Mac, I know that home run yesterday, it took you a second to figure out, A, where the ball was, B, if it was going to be foul or what was happening. At what point in this one did you realize, all right, yeah, this is definitely gone?
I'm being completely honest, it was one of those things. Out of his hand, it was just out of his hand. I knew, it was, I don't know, comfort thing maybe. I don't know if he left it up. he said over there that their coach said it was a good pitch. I mean, at the plate, it just looked like it was right there. When I hit it, I knew it was gone. I just blacked out and didn't even know what just happened. I felt like I was running down third baseline. Realized running first that I just won the game and that we continue to play tomorrow. And I'm happy that some of the guys that won't be here next year and stuff get to put that jersey on again, and that we get to just do it in general tomorrow. And, you know, as a team effort, we just need to keep rolling.
Jake, this might seem like a weird question because I know how happy you guys are right now, but the way you talked about Parrish, is part of you feel for a guy like that, the way he battled today?
Absolutely. I had the chance to pitch a little bit last year, and you know, I standing on second, you know, it's the changeup that you hit looked like any other changeup you threw all day that we swung through. He's a real competitor. You know, all game it looked like he was on the attack, like the whole entire game. I mean, even in the last inning, he struck out back-to-back batters. Like, I mean, he was locked in. He got you to two strikes. You know, and you know, I really do feel for him. You know, like I said, Florida State's a really good team. You don't just happen to come across 41 seasons. That doesn't just happen. You know, credit to their program and, you know, and what they've built here. It's really impressive. And, you know, you feel for everybody in that locker room. But baseball is a crazy game that will rip your heart out, and it will make you as happy as you can be. But, you know, and that's why baseball is what it is, and that's why we love it.
Any more questions?